hold on, I'm going to back it up. I'll give you the name of the joke first. So I'll explain it. All right. All right, you ready? All right, we're ready. So this man, and he has this big tree trunk. He's in a forest. And he comes across this log and he's just sleeping. All of a sudden he wakes up, stretches, gets up, shakes out, and he notices the chair there with his jacket. So he puts it on. And he's got this red jacket, red and black, with long sleeves, really comfortable. And then he notices, oh, I forgot my pants. Where's my pants? Oh, there they are. So he grabs them and puts it on. He's trying to fit into them, squeezing in there. He's just struggling a little bit. Gets them on. Okay, now I gotta go to work, but what are my things? I gotta get food for lunch. All right, let me see what I can cook. Oh, okay, so we got some bread here. Make myself a sandwich. And he puts it in a Ziploc bag and into his lunchbox. And then he gets coffee, packs that up, and puts that in the bag. I've got a sandwich, got a coffee. Wait, what am I forgetting? Ah, an apple. All right, I'll put that in there too. Packs it up, closes the box. All right, now I need, what else do I need? I also need my axe. It's a long stick, very sharp edges. All right, so he gets his jacket on, he grabs his axe, grabs his lunchbox, and he's ready to go. He opens up the door and walks out. Closes the door behind him, and with his things in tow, walks. And he's walking, and he's walking through the trees, and it's a beautiful day. The sun is shining. He's very happy. Now he hears the birds chirping, but he can't really hear them. But he sees them, hey, and he's waving to them. And there's this one tree that he sees. He's like, you know what? I think that's a good one. So he puts his box down. He grabs his axe and he starts chopping away at it. He's chopping it from every angle. And he's chopping and chopping. Puts the axe down. And then he screams, "Timber!" Tree falls. And he feels the vibrations. All right, good job. All right, I did good. So he takes his axe, takes his box, and he walks on through. And he's continuing to walk. And there he comes across, I think this is the perfect tree. So he puts his lunchbox down, he puts his jacket down, he rolls up his sleeves, he's all ready, picks up his axe, and now he's chopping away at the tree. He puts the axe down, he steps back, and yells again, "Timber!" And the tree falls, and he feels the vibrations. Yeah, that I felt, that was good. Ooh, you know what? I think I'm getting kind of hungry. I think I'm going to grab my food. So he opens up this lunchbox and gets his sandwich out. Opens the Ziploc bag and starts eating his sandwich. He's got, oh, that was really good. All right. That tasted really good. All right, I'm going to get my apple, shines it against his shirt. Yeah, I think it's shiny now. Yeah, it's got to be really good and shiny. And then he starts eating his apple till it's all gone. And then he takes his coffee and he starts to drink it. Ah, that's good. That's really good. He closes the lid and puts his coffee back in the box. All right, now I'm ready to go on. So he takes his axe, he takes his lunchbox, and he continues on. And as he's walking, he sees this huge tree, very thick, very tall. And he backs up and looks at it. Wow. All right. you know what, I think I could do this. Rolls up his sleeves, gets ready, gets his axe, and he's chopping away. As with all his might, he's chopping away. Okay. Sets his axe down and screams, "Timber!" And the tree wobbles. All right, let me try this again. Takes his axe, and he continues to chop away at the tree. Puts it down and screams again, "Timber!" And the tree just wobbles. Oh, I wonder what to do. Ah, I know. So who does he call? The tree doctor. And he pages him. "You know, I need you to come here and help me out. I need help with this tree. It won't go down." "All right, I'll come." "Okay." And he puts his phone back in his pocket and he waits. The tree doctor shows up. "Oh, hey. Oh, hey, what's up? How you doing? All right, so I need you to wait a minute. I need you to see this tree. So I don't know what to do. I've been chopping at it both sides and it won't go down." "Really? Yeah, really. Yeah, I've been working at it." "Okay. Give me one moment." He looks at the tree. He sizes it up. Takes out his stethoscope, starts listening to it. "Yeah, this tree's fine. It's healthy. Yeah, but I've been screaming timber. All right, well, maybe try it again. Maybe try something new." "Okay. All right, give me one moment. Wait, you gotta step back, though, okay? I need some space." He goes at it with the axe again. But does he scream this time? No. T-I-M-B-R starts fingerspelling timber against the tree, and sure enough, the tree goes down and falls and the ground shakes. Oh, right. Okay, the tree was deaf. I get it.